إن الحمد لله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس واتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد إن خير الحديث كتاب الله خير الهدي هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد يقول الله عز وجل ومن الناس من يتخذ من دون الله أندادا يحبونهم كحب الله والذين آمنوا أشد حبا لله Allah عز وجل spoke in the Quran that there are people who love, who call upon things beside Allah, and they love those elements, those objects, those, their gods, whatnot, extremely. In contrast, people who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they love Allah extremely. So this is a parallel Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala draws between two groups of people. One group, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala min dunillahi andada, they are people who call upon other things beside Allah. They care for something more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have other people, the Muslims, who love Allah more than anything else. They care for Allah more than anything else. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبَّ لِلَّهِ أَشَدُّ is a comparative word which simply says more than anything else. You love other things also. But this thing you love more than all other things. It's not saying that it's the only thing you got to love. Then nothing to compare with. If I say, if you pay attention to this, if I say this person becomes the first in the class, then I say, how many students in the class? Only one student. So it doesn't make any sense. One student, you're the first, you're the last. Doesn't matter. But when you have 10, and you are one out of all, then when this you're competing with others, and this becomes the top. When the dunya has many things that you like to love, among them Allah becomes the top of your love, then you have competed and succeeded. Before I go into details, let us start with an example. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala demanded his love from Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ibrahim has many things to give. Sheep, lamb, camel, food, dates, rice, whatever he's willing to give. But Allah said, I want something more than that. More than that. What do I want? Fast 30 days, 60 days, 700 days? No. Do tahajjud whole night for 60 years? No. I mean, what else you could want from him? I want your son. But take him for Allah, no. Slaughter for me. It's not just giving your son to study religion or give him up to somebody else, you know. Take him out from the earth. Why am I going to do that? To prove that he loves you more than anything. Can imagine the psyche of a person can think that. For them, can selling things in haram would be an issue? Can buying house and riba would be an issue? Who is willing to give his own son for Allah? Not give, take him out. Have son committed no crime. He did not do anything wrong. But still Allah wants to check him out. That whom you love, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبَّا لِلَّهِ. Do you really love me more than anything else around you, what you love? This is the point to know and think that where we belong. And before that, if I keep in mind, inshallah, I will talk about something about children when more people come. It is important to know. But my hope is the next generation. That's why I want to focus the young faces, those who are growing. I want to make them an impact in the life of others. Because those who reach certain age, it's difficult to change the gear because you've come to a level of saturation. So you have a lot of cultural baggage with you. It's difficult to move them around. I understand that. That's fine. But my focus is the next generation. They're going to take control over the destiny, inshallah, of this ummah. Having said this, لأن الناصر الذين آمنوا أشد حبا لله. الحديث صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من والده وولده والناس أجمعين، كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم، أخرجه إما البخاري ومسلم. That your iman is not complete. You're not a pure 100% a good Muslim. Why not? If you do not love, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before I talked about Allah, now I'm talking to the Prophet. الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. This is love of the Prophet now. Before the love of Allah. Love of the Prophet. What he said? That your iman is not complete. Even though I made Hajj 10 times? No. You do Qiyamul Layl every night? Fast every other day, Sawm Dawud? No. Why not? Allah said your iman is complete unless the love of the Prophet ﷺ supersedes over any other love. For example, love of my father, love of my mother, love of my children. It is vertical ascension and descension. That means going upwards, parents, grandparents, downwards, children, grandchildren. Your chain, your lineage, you love. Allah said this too. If you care, I want nasi ajma'in, and in case you end up loving somebody else more than that, just to cover all the ground, even anything else you love more than Allah's Prophet, your iman is not complete. Listen, what I just said, maybe it's a minute on this. Allah is my witness. If you write volumes after books from the beginning of the earth to the end of it, essence of this statement cannot be comprehended. It is so deep, so comprehensive, so intense and so detailed. With Allah's Prophet said, your iman is not complete. What I have if I don't have iman? That is not complete if you love the Prophet is not important than anything else. All of us guilty of this crime. All of us are guilty of this crime, period. Period. Forget your children and parents. You talk about money, forget Allah's Prophet. That comes first. You and I. I'm not talking about Joe in the street. I'm talking about Muhammad in the masjid. That's what I'm talking about. We are the people. Unless we accept that and find a method to rectify it and check ourselves every now and then, in a periodic manner, we'll be gone. With the salah, with the siyam, with the tawb, with the beard, nothing is going to come. Because Allah said, وَيْلُوا لِلْمُسَلِّينَ أَلَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ. Allah said, woe to those people who have been jailed up. Those who used to pray. I'm not talking about those who do not pray. I'm not talking about those who do not wear hijab. I'm talking about those who do those things. They are in a serious position. So it is not about those people used to pray, don't pray, those into haram, no, I'm talking about those into salah, into siyam, into hajj. For them, there's a warning of Jahannam. We ask Allah's protection from it because this matter is a serious matter. And it appears to be Muslim are taking it so easy. This is just another day of the week. That's not the case. This is an important matter. It requires important concession, thinking, and meditation for people that what I am heading, where is my life going to? I'm 20 years old, I'm thinking this way. I'm 40 years old, thinking the same manner. 60 years old, thinking the same thing. 80 years old, no change. Because there is no effort of changing. In physics, if there is a force applied to an element, it keeps moving. Unless another force objects to that, this should move until infinite. Until the end of time. Because unless there is a counter force applied to it, to cancel out that force or deviate the force. This is basic physics. Right? Unless there's a change and effort applied to the mind of the people, whether they're 20 years old or 120 years old, will not change because you don't want to change. And change never comes unless there's a conscious thinking about making a change. We have to start thinking about making a change. It is about us. It is not the physical appearance. It is the mental state of the person makes a lot of difference. So we have to think what I want to do. Ask a young kid, go to school, come home, summer, camp, play around. Okay, next year, after that, go to college, work. Everything's chopped out, planned out. MashaAllah. What about Allah? I'm trying. You're not trying. You're pretending. You're not trying. So we have to take this Yidushan conscious effort, saying that really, do we love Allah? Do we really love the Prophet Allah? There's no point pretending. You know where we are, I know where I am. So let us be straight to the point. Another thing, a lot of people, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, people are bid'ah, people who do innovation, they do mawlud al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they cry in the mawlud. This is not the love of Allah and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Matter of fact, this is a joke. This is a joke. That this is not the love of Allah. Love of Allah and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a whole different ballgame. It's a whole different ballgame. I'm going to come to it. Matter of fact, let me tell you now, because I'm going to forget. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم كل أمتي يدخلون الجنة إلا من أبى. All my entire nation will go to the paradise except those who don't want to do it. Those who decline, those who resist to go to paradise. Who in their sane mind do not want to go to Jannah? But this is a little more technical than that. Rasulullah said, Sahaba was a shock. Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, woman, I mean, who else? I mean, they're shocked. Rasulullah had to explain what it implied by the meaning of declining, resisting, go to paradise. He said, Man asani dakhala al-jannah. Wa man asani faqad aba, kama qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whoever obeys me, not only cry for me, not only love me, not only say that, you know, this and that, good, but whoever obeys me, follow the rules applied by me, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for the pleasure of Allah azza wa jal, not just do it, it has to have with ikhlas, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, upon the perimeter established by the sharia of this deen, they are going to go to the paradise. That means those who buy house in Riba, those women don't wear proper hijab, not hijab, proper hijab from a sharia perspective, they are not into this group, by the way, for information. And they are which group they belong to? Umar Asani, and those who have disobeyed me, they decline to go to paradise. I mean, what a simple first grade level discussion that is. However, this discussion could exceed the PhD level discussion. Why? Because it has so much to offer. But since kids are here, my point is this, is Allah and His Prophet more important to you? Is it? If not, believe it, you're not among them. If Salah comes, Siyam comes, Hukam of Allah comes, something else becomes more important to you, then you're not into this group who's going to paradise. I told you in the hadith of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Is buying house in riba is more important? Sister, showing off your beauty to others when Allah made it haram for you, it become more important? You are challenging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Perhaps this may lead to the Jahannam. And Jahannam, nara Jahannam ashad dahar. And the fire of hellfire is hotter than the fire of the dunya. Just for the information. So we need to take it serious. This is the month of Ramadan. Let us change a life. It must need a turning point in life. Many people think religion is just ritual. It has rituals, but this is not all of it. Rituals must project to something more than that, which is the essence of the religion. Many people make salah and siyam and all this, but look at the family life, how they conduct themselves. This is not Muslim. This is not Allah and His Prophet. This is not the way a Muslim lives. But they are okay with that. Because my generation been doing, my grandfather, my mother, uncle been doing it, I've been doing it too. I'm a Muslim, but I do this thing also. It doesn't work this way. It is summer, but it still snows. It doesn't happen this way. You understand what I'm saying? It is summer, but it's still snowing. It never snows in August. You dream that, you make a mistake. You say, it's August, but it's still snow. It doesn't work this way. I'm a Muslim, but I also do this. You can do also this. Say that I'm not a Muslim. You make a decision. You want to grow up adults, let us act like adults. I'm a Muslim, I fulfill this requirement. I'm not a Muslim, mashallah, they need something else. This is straight and simple to the point. I mean, what's so difficult to understand? Oh, my friends won't like it if I do this. But Allah won't like it, doesn't matter to you? My friends, you know, I will have no friends. But you have Allah as your friends, what else do you need? Wallahu alayhi amanu khujum min al-zulumati ila an-nur. Allah is the friend of the believer. Not only friend, a guardian, protector, sustainer, Allah. Your friend is not a protector. Your friend is not your guardian. Your friend is not your sustainer. Your friend doesn't give you life. Your friend doesn't take your life. But Allah does all of that, Bob. But you take Allah as your friend, but Allah is not important in your life. Alladhina amanu ashaddu hubban lillah. Those who believe, those who are Muslim, they love Allah the most. And nothing else comes close. I was surprised many years ago, about 25 years ago, 30 years ago, in Brooklyn, there are some brothers from certain countries, and I wished to be, you know, all together very tight back in the day. So one day, after many years, I've seen my brothers in the masjid all the time, Salah and Fajr and Isha and all this, mashallah. But he had a family now, so one day he passed by the masjid, Salaam alaykum wa rahmatullah, and his family is behind him. Look at him, subhanAllah. This man makes Salah and Fajr in the masjid and Isha, and the rest of the family look like that. There must be a problem somewhere. There must be some disconnect. There must be some misunderstanding somewhere. Something doesn't sound right. Something doesn't sound right. This person has a family like this. Something is not right about this place. So we need to think, where are we going wrong? And Allah says, فَإِنَّ تَذْهَبُونَ. What are you heading to? What's wrong? يَا أَيُّهَا الْإِنسَانِ.
Oh mankind, ما غرك بربك الكريم? What led you astray from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What led you in a different track? Something ain't right about it. Some people said, I've been to da'wah for 20 years, mashallah. Da'wah to whom? Allah said, anfusakum. Anfusakum, linafsi. First for yourself. You're doing da'wah, I look at you, come to your home, subhanallah. I sometimes don't know whose house I come to. This your house, brother? Are you doing da'wah? Whom are you doing da'wah to? The cats and mouse? It doesn't look like you're doing a da'wah. Because you're da'wah to nafs first, to your family first. If you forget my family, who's supposed to come inside my house? Who's supposed to come to my wife? Brother Abdullah should come to my wife. It's your job. But, you know, people are into this notion of religion somewhere else, forget their own home. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kullukum ra'in, kullukum mas'ulun ala ra'ati. Kama qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Another ayat Allah said, that ar-rijal, men, you know, male and men are not the same thing. This is a detailed discussion. I'm not going to go into this. This is biological men versus rijal. In Quranical language, rijal is the men have leadership. Ar-rijal yuqawwamuna 'ala an-nisa. The men. Zaid bin Usama bin Zaid radiallahu anhu, by age 18, was the men. Men going to Spain, men. And I have 80 years old, act like children. So there is a difference. It's not the age. It's not the size. It's the mind of the person makes the men. الرجال كومون على النساء بما فضل الله بعدكم على بعض. Allah men make the men imam, but they act like they're in the back. They need to come to the front, get rid of the fear, and be straight to the point. It's not about being aggressive. It's about culturing. When I talk, many people think it's about being aggressive. That's not the case. That's not the case. I go through my children discussions, subhanAllah, I think in an average per day, at least an hour, every day. Alhamdulillah, walillahi hamd, that alhamdulillah, they are better than most of the people as it appears to be from outside. And I work with them per day in average, sometimes per day, 2-3 hours. When they talk about the same thing over again, you know, listen, if I dhikr, in dhikr tan fa'lun. How many times Allah talk about in the Quran about taqwa? More than 25 times, taqwa. One time was enough. Allah said, fear Allah, fear the Jahannam. How many times do you repeat it? It's not one time. But Allah repeats. It's important. The mind may pick up information different time in different mood. So we need to be pushing, pushing for it. And Allah said, fastabiqul khayrat. Compete in good. So you have to try hard for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not enough that you pray. It's not enough your beard. It's not enough. It's not, sister. It's not. It may appear to be a lot because a lot of people giving a lot of credit. A lot of credit. Some people tell my son, oh mashallah, you're doing this, you're doing that. I say, oh, people of this caliber, I tell my son, people of your time, many will be in Jahannam, may Allah protect us from it. What is the hadith? Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Abu Hurairah, do you know the three people will be called upon the day of judgment? One of them, Rajulun, Jama'ul Quran, kama qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of them, who memorized the book of Allah, who is the ulama of the Quran. They will be in the hellfire because of lack of ikhlas, not an application when they learn. So yes, your beloved son come to the masjid, do qaymullah, good, but you still have to tell them people like this also is in Jahannam. So you have to be cautious. What are you doing or what are you doing it for? There is no blank check until you die. Allah said, فَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيكَ لِكَ سُورَ الْحَجْرِ Surah 15, the last ayah. Allah said, make ibadah of Allah until you die. Effort has to be consistent in a constant basis, pushing for it, racing to Allah's mercy. It's not sitting back and looking and watching television. This is not this religion. It must be something else entirely. There has to have some level of seriousness in the religion. It is not enough that my little kid comes with his kids like his size, making salah with the parents. Parents are excited, rightfully so. Rightfully so. But this is not the kid I'm talking about. I'm talking about the kid become 21. That's what I'm talking about. Become 18. That's what I'm talking about. At this point, it doesn't have discretion. Whatever you say, the lessons to it doesn't have a mind of his own. But when time comes, association with people makes a lot of difference. Brother comes, oh brother, my son is dead, what can I do now? Brother, are you expecting miracles? Are you expecting miracles? Brother, you plant a seed of apple, orange will never come out of that tree. Impossible. No matter how much genetic engineering, it's not going to come out. It doesn't work this way. You planted a seed of kufr from early age without knowing it, and full-blown kufr just appeared from him or her. It's not a coincidence. It just doesn't happen like this. Many people take exams, even multiple choices, they expect to get 100 out of it. Statistically, it's impossible. Almost impossible. They just say, I'm going to choose something, it may work out. It doesn't work out this way. It's not going to work out like that. Inshallah, one day I just keep making dua. A lot of people say to me, brother, make dua, inshallah. So, brother, don't go to work and make dua, see the food comes to your table. This is pathetic. Playing with the religion. Let them make da'wah. Yes, you have to make da'wah. Before that, must be an action. Rasulullah, whom Allah loves the most, who Allah responds his du'a to, and he has to go to Badr. He could sit down and make du'a from home. Allah take care of the Badr. Allah said, go there. Go in Firoh. I said, go. And then we'll take over business. Allah said, لَكَدْ نَصَرَكُمُ اللَّهُ بِبَدْرٍ أَنْتُمْ أَذِلَّا. Did Allah help you when you're so weak in Badr? But you got to be there to be helped. But we are sitting home and asking for help. It doesn't work this way. So the point here is, love of Allah and to our children, the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not just appear from the blues. It requires a constant effort. Have to be serious about it. The key word here is conscious effort, not a ritual effort without thinking. Difference between a conscious effort and ritual effort. Ritual effort comes from Allah. That's ritual effort. You have no mind in there. You don't think. You need to sit down, you make fourth, that's enough. If you don't want to make sunnah, that's fine. This is not wajib, by the way. You don't want to make sunnah, that's fine. Go home. And think 2 hours about how can I change my life. Allah is my witness. That is much better than 2 rak'ah sunnah, because that change in your life will bring 30 more rak'ah sunnah. Long term. There's a long term benefit. You have to understand. Think, tafakkur. Allah talks about it in Surah Ali Imran, Surah number 3, verse 190. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَرِ إِلَىٰ آيَاتِ الْإِلَىٰ الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ. They think. The intelligent people sit down and think, what can I do with my life? How can I make a change? Muslims should be the best of them, example in the universe. If you look at a Muslim in their job, in their work, being a neighbor, say, this is a Muslim. How do I know? I never talked to him, but these behavior things look like he must be Muslim. Or she must be a Muslim, the way the person carries themselves. It must be a Muslim. But how do you know? Because the behavior of the person say, Muslims are supposed to behave like they must be a Muslim. That is us should have been. But reality is exactly opposite of that. Coming to the point, loving Allah and His Prophet and making a commitment to this religion. There's another ayat. I mean, this is a lengthy discussion. I have to cut it short. I have a meeting after that too. Surah 9, Surah Al-Tawbah, verse number 24. I'd like you to go and check it. Surah 9. Surah Bara'ah, Surah Tawbah, two names for it. This is the one the surah starts with something, some heavy duty information at the beginning of it. You read, you enjoy it. Allah says, قُلْ إِنْ كَانَ أَبَاؤُكُمْ وَأَبْنَاؤُكُمْ وَأَخْوَاتُكُمْ وَأَزْوَاجُكُمْ وَعَشِيرَتُكُمْ وَأَمْوَالٌ اقْتَرَفْتُمُوهَا وَتِجَارَةٌ تَخْشَوْنَ كَسَادَهَا وَمَسَاكِنُ تَرْضَوْنَهَا أَحَبَّ إِلَيْكُم مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَجِهَادٍ فِي سَبِيلِهِ فَتَرَبَّصُوا حتى يأتي بالله أمري والله لا يهدي القوم الفاسقين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said 70 ayat. I'm going to summarize it. Allah said, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell the people, قل إن كان آباؤكم وأبناؤكم وأزواجكم إخوانكم وأزواجكم وعشيرتكم. Oh Muhammad, tell them, if your father, your parents, your children, your spouses, your neighbors, your brothers, if they are important to you, from the human kind, if they're important to you. Number one. Then Allah says another group of things Allah talks about. Your wealth. Allah talks about the wealth which you love. Allah talks about your house, big house with 5 bedrooms. You love that so much. Your business, you're worried about losing some money because you are too much into ibadah. You may lose some money. If you think those things, Allah says, Fatarabbasu. Wait. Yes, Allah be amri. Wait after Allah's judgment comes on you. This is a threat. Allah said, wait till the punishment of Allah comes to you. Be careful about that. Allah saying, be wait. فَتَرَبَّسُ. It's not sabr of good sabr. It's sabr of worry and anxiety. Allah said, worry. فَتَرَبَّسُ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهُ بِأَمْرِ. When dunya becomes important to you, then Allah said, be careful about it. Then Allah said, وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْفَاسِقِينَ. These are the people of fifth fasiq. By deduction, by conclusion, it says, above people who do, Allah is warning them, and they are fasiq, and Allah will not guide them. Imagine this statement. We love the dunya. We love our parents more than Allah and His Prophet. We love our wealth more than Allah and His Prophet. We love our children more than Allah and His Prophet. Our business, our house more important than Allah and His Prophet. This is fact. Allah says, if that is above is true, then you are fasiq, and Allah is not going to guide you. And not only this, Allah is warning, فَتَرَبَّدُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهُ بِأَمْرِهِ. Be worried about it. All these characteristics is among us. Even though it's beard and salah and qiyam and siyam, mashallah, but that's not enough. That's not enough because the ritual doesn't cut it. You need more than that. An intellectual effort to think, how can I change my life today? I am going to write down with paper, these are the things I have to get rid of. These are the things I have to start with. And then, inshallah, I make dua to Allah. There will be effort after Ramadan. Brother, Ramadan is only 1 month, 11 left over. 11 left over. You don't eat in this month for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You give up the food which you love. Nobody stop you of the money. Food is legally halal. The halal food, halal fried chicken. You look at it, you say, this is halal food, I have the halal money. Nothing stop me from eating, only the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only the pleasure of Allah. If this mentality, not only siyam, because it is, honestly, this is a ritual we do. We never think why we do it. It has become a practice, generation after generation, without knowing what we do. Many people sing songs, don't know what are they singing. So it's like this, we're singing Islamic song, and over again, just part of the club. This membership is not going to do it, you have to do more than that. Which is, that you have to think, why do I fast? Why do I eat in Maghrib? Why not in Isha? Why? What difference does it make if I eat in Isha? Why don't I eat at all? But I did what Prophet said, don't eat from Fajr to Maghrib, I didn't do it, I do want to extra. But this deen is about not what you feel, what you want to do. This deen is about sama'na, we heard it, ata'na, we comply with it. This is this deen. This is this deen that you love Allah and His Prophet, you must be obedient to them, and that will bring success. In every aspect of life, there is no 50%. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu udkhulu. Come into the religion, fisilna kaffa, completely 100%. وَلَا تَتَّبِيَ خُطُوَةِ الشَّيْطَانِ. This ayah didn't end there. There's an extension next to it, saying that not only come to the religion, but also you don't follow the shaitan. I do this, but I also do this. It's not going to work like that. You do this and this only and nothing else besides it. This level of iman, this level of action, manifest الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبَّ لِلَّهِ. That these are the people who love Allah the most. Nothing else comes close. If that really comes, again, this is between a man and Allah or a woman and Allah. Let me repeat this and let me make it clear. What I just said all this time is a lot of words. End of the day, what that is? It is a thing. It is a thing. What is the thing? I don't know. It is a thing between a servant of Allah and Allah Azza wa Jalla. And nothing else comes in between. And nobody else knows. It's not your mother, your father, your wife, your children. It's not about that. It's about you going to your grave by yourself. You in your Qiyamah by yourself. You either in Nar or in Jannah by yourself. That's all it matters. So it is between you and Abd and Abd of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Azza wa Jalla. So he said, Allah, this is a confession. You already know what's going on with me. I want to make an effort. Allah, I'm going to try these things, but without your help, I can move. So Allah, I ask you for your help. Tawfiq come from Allah. A sincere dua to Allah. Let's say, Adu'u me. Come, call upon me. I'll respond to it. And toward the last one third of the night, come for two rak'ah. It'll take 5 minutes, 3 minutes. Make wudu 2 minutes and two rak'ah, 3 more minutes, 5 minutes. Two rak'ah only. Getting up in Ramadan. Last day, right before four, maybe 5 minutes, 10 minutes before that. Before the last one third of the night finishes, Allah said, help me die and finish this. Is there anybody is asking me, I can give them. I respond to the dua. Is there anybody out there when they ask me something? And we're busy eating. You can imagine the Lord of the universe coming, asking, do you need something? I said, I'm busy not eating. Imagine that. Your boss comes to the office, I'm calling for a meeting. He said, do your meeting, I'm busy. Then he said, you know what, door is this way, exit, I'm calling the security. You out. You don't speak with that level of dare to your boss. Allah Rabbul Alameen asking, do you need something I can give you? And Allah is important. Allah is powerful. He is the owner. He is the giver of the life and death. He is all. All in all. We are nothing. And the way we act, it appears to be that we are something and he is not. Imagine that he is. When a woman, for example, comes in the street, wear perfume, right? With lipstick and all this, walk in the street, they're simply saying, Allah, I know the rules, what you put, really, you can forget about that. Yes, I ain't going for that. You find it with somebody else. Inna Allah ghaniyun al alameen. Antum al fuqara ila Allah. You are beggars in front of Allah, and Allah is the richest one. He's the ghani. And he is telling you, do this. Al Jabbar al Qahar, he's telling you, and he said, you know, later for you. It doesn't work this way. And this child from day one has to be protected, raised in a proper manner. At least the minimum you give to Islamic school. Believe it, Islamic school is just the beginning. Many people think, I put them in Islamic school, they didn't become Ibn al Qayyim. I say, you've been daydreaming for too long. You need to wake up, smell it off. What Islam is going to do? Only protect from major haram, most likely. That's all it's going to do. Come home, brother, I work two jobs. Why need two jobs? I need to have a big house. It's not Shia requirement to have a big house, by the way, for information. One brother told me I was so pissed off, time is short, I was so pissed off, somebody said, brother, kids need a house. And the brother in New York City, how many houses do you have? Do you know? I don't know. But I'm going to make some sense out of it. You know, do you see any house more than one floor in there? Multifamily houses? There are tons of it. Therefore, there is few owners and more tenants. Is this correct? Yes, it makes sense. If you have 500,000 houses, and each of them is three floors, there are 15,000 people can live there. So therefore, three times, 150,000 people, that's three times more. So there is three times more tenants than the owner. So why do you have to be owner? Why don't you suddenly become a big shabby owner? And more often than you come from another country, and overnight, you know, people born and raised here live in an apartment and you need a house overnight. Why? But your thing is going down the drain, that's not important. So when you give focus on the money, brother, I'm trying. You don't understand how to try. Your children come every day from day one. If remember the fear of Allah, the ni'mah of Jahannam and the fear of Jahannam. And loving Allah's prophets, consistently putting in their mind, setting an example for it, and never give importance to the dunya to the kid. Little kids go, for example, I go to the store to buy something for Eid. I say, buy this, from the sunnah. This from the sunnah for Eid day, to entertain the family. So I buy them, take it. And let me tell you some story. After 10 years, will the shark stay with you? He said, no. And the definition is garbage. There's no value to this. And yes, you have to start with kids. My kid, 10 years old, 8 years old, start with them. I said, this shirt, you're excited? Yes. But 10 years later, will it have any value? He said, no way. He said, this life is just like this. Today you're excited, tomorrow you have no excitement about something. This dunya is like this. Don't get attached to something which you cannot hold it. I said, can you take something in your grave? Son, I remember my kid, when he was 6 years old. I said, you know when people die in grave, they take their watches with them? Obviously, the answer is no. Eyeglasses? No. I said, didn't take it. Why not? They can't take it. They can't take it. That means whatever you have in your possession, today or tomorrow, nothing is forever. Is that so? I said, yes. If something is not ever, don't hold on to it. But Allah is forever. In Allah, Allah is forever. Hold on to Him, He'll never drop you. This has to be culture from early. It's not about the recitation of Quran or takfir. This is important, but that's not enough. I mean, many people into doing takfir. Takfir is recitation, memorization. Arabic, Chinese, Italian, doesn't matter. This is another language. For kids, it's just memorization. Could be poetry. Doesn't make a difference. But the essence of religion has to be cultured in the mind. If not now, then become 20, then become 40, 80, the person will never change. The point is, my brother, this message has to be understood in with due diligence. We need to go home and think about it. Why this is happening to us? Something in us. Many people think that everything is pious, but still things are not working. It just cannot be. If you build a bridge, you're a civil engineer, build a bridge, I say, everything is right, the bridge just falls apart. I said, for sure, nothing, everything cannot be right. That's why it's falling apart. You can't say everything is right and things is also falling apart. It doesn't work this way. Something definitely is wrong, you just don't know what is wrong. So we have something major wrong with ourselves. We couldn't figure out yet what that is. We have to give effort to find out what is the problem, take decisive action to fix it, or call the help of stuff from Allah.
What do you want to do?
إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. To finish up in conclusion, that what I started with, Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, ومن الناس ما يتخذ من دون الله أندادا يحبونهم كحب الله والذين آمنوا أشد حبا لله. People love something more than Allah سبحانه وتعالى, rightfully so. But those who believe it, they're supposed to be loving Allah the most. When Allah demands something for them, whether giving up a friend, giving up the job, giving up some money, giving up the riba, giving up the khanzir and khamra from the store and their business, lying, cheating, deceiving, women putting hijab on, giving up the perfume and makeup and fake up, Allah made it haram. They like this, but they say, Allah, I love Allah more than that. So therefore, what I'm going to do, I'm going to give it up because Allah wants it from me. Allah wants his son Ismail from Ibrahim, Allah gave it up. Ibrahim gave it up. Allah is only asking very little from us. Will you give it up? If you don't, Allah is a warning. Allah says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, wait for it. Allah's punishment may come. So you got to be serious and careful with that. I concluded the hadith of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I give two hadiths, which one I said at the beginning, which many people won't hear. I'm going to repeat that. One hadith of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ثلاثة من كنا وجد حلاوة الإيمان أن يكون الله رسوله أحب إليه مما بينهما يحب المرأة لا يحبه إلا الله إلا لله. The third one I'm going to talk about, two things. Allah said, Rasulullah said, if you have three things with you, you will really get the flavor of Iman. You will really get it. That means you mean to tell me I really don't taste Iman yet? Most likely not. Most likely not. Because if your mouth is closed, how are you going to taste something? Our heart is closed. With this heart, you can taste Iman. That's the problem. Heart is blind. إِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَلْ أَبْصَارُ وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَلْ قُلُوبُ الَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ. Heart is blind. That's why you're not testing the Iman. Iman is, Rasulullah said three things. One of them, that Allah and His Prophet is more beloved to them than more than anything else. أَيَكُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْهِ مِمَّا سِوَاهُمَا. Second one is more important than them. Not that Allah and His Prophet is important than them. And they love them more. Not only this. If they love somebody else, they also love for the sake of Allah. This is even more difficult. You love someone, person has money, has power, has some connection. That's what you love somebody for. They said you love someone, you love everything less than Allah's Prophet, that's for sure. Then if you love something else beside Allah in a lesser scale, you do that also for the sake of Him. You get the point? So you love only Allah's Prophet more than anything else. And if you love something beside Allah in a lower scale, you do that also for His pleasure. So everything is about your life in the salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alamin. Everything for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you do that, if you can do it, يوم القيامة Allah said, سلام عليكم تبتم فادخلوا خالدين. Come, welcome, good job, well done, come to the paradise. Angel waiting for you. VIP treatment, go to the paradise. If not, there's a lot of hardship waiting for us. The concluding hadith also Rasulullah said, كل أمتي يدخلون الجنة إلا بالفرد. My entire ummah will go to paradise. I talked about this, repeating for people who came late. Sorry, unfortunately many people come late in Jummah. This is a sad story, but that shows that what they love more, Allah or the dunya. That's an example. Anyway, coming to the point, he said that my ummah, all of them goes to paradise except those who don't want to do it. Sahaba said, who doesn't want to go to paradise? Rasulullah said, من أطاني, whoever obeys me, دخل الجنة, goes to paradise. ومن عصاني, those who disobey me, فقط أبا, and this is the one doesn't want to go to paradise. By extension of a logical deduction, they want to go to hellfire. That's the one. So you and I make a decision, what do you want to do? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open our heart and guide us to right. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana, israfana fi amrina, wa thabbit aqdamana, wa ansurna ala qawmina. Allahumma ihsina hasanatan fi umuri kullaha, wa ajirna min khayri ad-dunya, wa 'adhabal akhirah. أخي مسلم رحمة الله.